Hello everyone, David Navara is a Czech chess grandmaster and he is the highest rated Czech chess player. He won the Czech championship 7 times and he got his grandmaster title at the age of 17. But this game was played in 1998, so he was 13 when this game was played. He's playing against Jan Helbich, and I couldn't really find any information on Mr. Helbich or a photo of him. As you can see, there's the guy with the hoodie again. But I did find the information that he was rated around 2250. So, you know, a pretty strong opponent. And, although this game is a pretty theoretical game, it's pretty much all the way the main line of the Nydorf. The variation that Navara plays is quite interesting, and it kind of resembles a game Michal Tal would play. Like I said, it was played in 1998 in Olomouc in the Czech Republic. The tournament was called the Energy Cup. So let's see this game. Navarro is white and Helbich is black. We have e4, c5, the Sicilian defense, knight to f3, d6, we have d4, c captures on d4, knight captures on d4, and knight to f6. We have knight to c3 and now a6, so transposing into the Nydorf variation. Bishop to g5, we have e6, and here Navara plays f4. But it's interesting, before this f4 move, in the older days, queen to f3 was the main line. And there is a very interesting game between David Bronstein and Miguel Nydorf in a game with this variation that I will show maybe even tomorrow. And it's only after that game that the move f4 was introduced into theory. So we have f4, bishop to e7, queen to f3, queen to c7, queenside castle, knight b to d7, bishop to d3, and this is all still the theory of the main line of the Nydorf. b5, we have rook h to e1, and bishop to b7. And still this is this is the theory of the main line. And this is considered to be a completely equal position. If you would ask Garry Kasparov, for example, who is better in this position, he would say, in this position, the better player is better. So we have queen to g3, and now b4. And now, what does white do with this knight? Obviously, he can go to b1, he can go to e2. If he goes to e2, he kind of loses a pawn here. So, in this position, Navara played knight to d5, attacking this queen on c7. But this isn't really a piece sacrifice, as this is a well-known move in a lot of variations of the Nydorf. So we have e captures on d5, and we have e5 here, now attacking this knight on f6. We have d captures on e5, f captures on e5, and now knight to h5. And this is attacking this bishop on g5. So moves that come to mind are queen to g4, queen to h4. White should defend this bishop as, bishop captures on g5 comes with check, and the white is already down a piece. But here, Navara plays a Tal move, and he plays e6 in this position. And, the fireworks start. What does black play here? Well, of course, black will capture the queen, as this is objectively the strongest move. He plays knight captures on g3 here, and we have e captures on f7. And black doesn't really have a choice here. He does have to capture the pawn, as, king to f8 or king to d8 both lose to knight to e6, and this is getting the queen back. But even here, black would still be better. But after e captures on f7, he played king captures on f7, and we have rook captures on e7 with check. Here, black has to go king to g8. If he goes king to f8, you get knight to e6 check, king to g8, and now rook captures on g7 with checkmate. So after rook to e7 check, king to g8 is forced, and here Navara plays h captures on g3. And, what does black play here? There are a couple of options here, but probably best is to capture this g3 pawn with the queen, because if white will be able to consolidate with bishop to f4, this could be annoying for black. So he does, he plays queen captures on g3, and we have knight to e6 now, as the queen was attacking this bishop on g5. We have queen to e5 by Helbich, and Navara goes rook to f1. And what does black play here? Well, he's not really worried about Navarro capturing here on g7, as black would be left up a rook in this variation. So he plays knight to f8. He wants to exchange this knight here. And here Navarro finds a very interesting move. He plays bishop to f5. And what does black play here? We have bishop to c8 now, attacking this knight, and again a very interesting move by Navarro. He plays rook to e8, and this is a very annoying move, as the black cannot capture this knight here. If he plays bishop captures on e6, he gets bishop captures on e6, and this is with check. The knight can't capture the bishop as it's pinned, so black doesn't really have a move other than to capture with the queen. So queen captures on e6, but this gets rook f captures on f8 with checkmate. So after this rook to e8 move, Helbig's best move would have been king to f7, actually, here, and this, with an equal position, but with an equal position for an engine, maybe not for a human with a low time control. So Helbig played bishop to b7 here. And here Navarro finds a deadly move. This is quite a move. He plays bishop to g6. And with this move, he's threatening rook captures on f8 with checkmate, and also bishop to f7 with checkmate. And there really isn't a way to stop both of these threats. Helbig finds a way. He plays queen to f6. He has to give back the queen. So we have bishop captures on f6, g captures on f6, and better than g captures on f6 would have been to capture this rook. Rook captures on e8. But Helbig played g captures on f6, and here Navarro plays rook captures on f6. And in this position, it doesn't matter what black plays, he's getting checkmated one way or the other. If he plays something like, for example, rook captures on e8, he gets bishop to f7 checkmate, and this is actually what happened in the game. This is the final position of the game. But even if he doesn't capture the rook on e8, for example, if he plays h captures on g6, you get rook f captures on f8 with check, king to h7, and rook captures on h8, also with a very nice checkmate, the knight is covering g7. This wasn't played after this. After this g captures here, this was the final position, bishop to f7 checkmate. So yeah, a very nice idea, and although it was a very theoretical line, I don't think this queen sacrifice was actually invented by the board. I do believe it was a home preparation, as this was a very analyzed variation of the Nidorf. So yeah, a very nice game by the 13-year-old Navarro, and it really did remind me of Tal's games in the Nidorf when he played with the white pieces. So yeah, that's the game. I do hope you enjoyed it. As usual, you can check two of my previous videos here. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you soon.